Hi, welcome to the channel NCERT Maths Tutor. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Also click the bell icon to get regular notification. In this video, I am explaining about exercise 10.2, question number 16 and 17 solution. Question number 16, the length L in centimeter of a copper rod is a linear function of its Celsius temperature. C. In an experiment, if L is equal to 124.942 when C is equal to 20 and L is equal to 125.134 when C is equal to 110, express L in terms of C. So in this question, they have given the length L as well as the C, that is the Celsius temperature. So we can take here the coordinate values as C as well as L. The C is the Celsius temperature and L is the length. So from this particular question, you can see that they have given two different values for C as well as L. That is, the first value here, it is given that L is equal to 124.942 when C is equal to 20. So C is equal to 20 and 124.942 we can take as one set of value. Then also they have given the another set of value, L is equal to 125.134 when C is equal to 110. So when C is equal to 110, the L value is given as 125.134. So we know here these two values, and each value consists of two points, that is, one is the Celsius temperature, another one is the length. That means here in this case we can apply the two point formula, that is, y minus y1 is equal to y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1 into x minus x1. Now in the question they have asked us to find out, that is, we need to express the L in terms of C. So directly you can take here the point as this, you can take as x1 y1, and this value you can take as x2 y2, or in the formula itself you can make the changes, or directly you can substitute the value. So the same formula we can write here in terms of L and C as in this way, that is, L minus L1 y1. We are taking here C as a x value and L as a y value. So here I can write L minus L1, that is equal to y2 minus y1, that is L2 minus L1 divided by x2 minus x1, x is here C, so C2 minus C1 into C minus C1. So like this way also you can make the changes in the formula, or directly you can substitute the value. So now here I am taking those two values, one is the Celsius temperature and another one is the length. Let us take this one as x1, this one as y1, or let us take this one as c1, l1, and then this as c2, l2. So in this formula, directly substitute the value. So here we have L minus L1 is 124.942, that is equal to L2. L2 is here 125.134 minus L1 is 124.942 divided by C2, C2 is 110 minus C1, that is 20, that is into C minus C1, C minus 20. Next here we have L minus 124.942 is equal to, this becomes 0.192 divided by 110 minus 20, that is 90, into C minus 20. So we need to write the equation in terms of L, that is, we need to express the value in terms of C. That means we need here L value. So L is equal to, this I am taking to right hand side. So we have 0.192 divided by 90 into C minus 20 plus 124.942. Question number 17. The owner of a milk store finds that he can sell 980 liters of milk each week at rupees 14 liters and 1220 liters of milk each week at rupees 16 rupees per liter. Assuming a linear relationship between selling price and demand, how many liters could he sell weekly at rupees 17 per liter? So now in this case, see, they have given us two values. One is the rupees per liter, another one is the total number of liters for that particular rupees. So we have here two values. That means we can take here x and y value. X we can take as a rupees, or y we can take as a liter, total number of liters of milk. So based on this, we can have two values, and also they have given two values. See, for 14 liters, the owner can sell 980 liters of milk. Sorry, for 14 rupees per liter, the owner can sell 980 liters of milk. That means 1 point we can have as 14 and 980. Next, another one is for 16 rupees per liter. For that, he can sell 1220 liters. So we can have the second point as 16 and 1220. Now here, as we know 2 points, we can apply 2 point form equation. Y minus y1 is equal to y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1 into x minus x1. In this, substitute the value. Let us take this one as x1 y1 and this as x2 y2. So y minus y1, that is 980, is equal to y2 minus y1, that is 1220 minus 980, divided by x2 minus x1, 16 minus 14 into x minus 14. Y minus 980 is equal to, this becomes 240, 16 minus 14, that is 2, into x minus 14. Then we have here y minus 980, this becomes 120 into x minus 14. So y minus 980 is equal to 120 into x, 1 minus 120 into 14. That is, y minus 980 is equal to 120x minus 1680. So 120x, bring this y to this side, so minus y is equal to 1680 minus 980. I am taking this value to this side. So we have here 120x minus y is equal to 700. So we got, this is the equation of the line. But in the question, they have asked us to find out how many liters could he sell weekly for rupees 700 per, 17 rupees per liter. So that is asked, that we need to calculate. That means here x value is given, we need to find out the y value. Now we can easily find out that, as we know the equation. So for in this equation, just substitute the x value, that is rupees per liter. X is equal to 17. So 120 into 17 minus y is equal to 700. That is, if you take y to this side, so we have y is equal to, this becomes 2040 minus 700. This I am taking to this side. So we have here y is equal to 1340. So he will sell weekly 1340 liters milk at the rate of rupees 17 per liter. Thanks for watching.